So, in the last lecture, we have derived the formulas from the master formula. We have seen how the interval is having the effect on the formulas, and we have also seen that how the function type affects the formula. So, if we know the function type, then it is a benefit for us that it will reduce our work. Okay, so now we'll see more on the integral formulas. We'll see more on the formulas that we required, and then we'll go for finding the Fourier series, and then we'll go for the analysis of the function, which are the frequency components present in that particular function. Okay, so now onwards, we'll be looking for the frequency components in that function. So you need to remember one thing, that every function that satisfies the Dirichlet's conditions, we are able to use the Fourier series representation for having the representation of that function, or we can have the components of that particular signal, and then we can represent that signal using this component. Okay, and the number of more components we find, we can represent that signal in a very fine way. Okay. So actually, what we are doing here, we are in the previous chapter, we have transmitted the signal. That means we were having a time signal, then we convert it to frequency signal, then we converted that frequency signal is transmitted through a channel. Okay, and now when it is received, okay, so that signal, frequency signal was transmitted through the channel, and then at the receiver's end, the frequency signal was received. And then we converted it using inverse Laplace transform to a time signal. And now the question is, how correct that time signal we are able to get? Okay, so more the terms we find in Fourier series, correct the signal we'll be getting. And that's why we are going to approximate that signal, and we are going to get the more and more accurate signal, so that we'll have less loss in communication. So this Fourier series also works as the filter to noise, because when the signal is transmitted through the channel, okay, it gets contaminated with the noise present in that channel or present in that medium. And now we are going to filter out that noise, and we are going to reconstruct our original signal using this Fourier series. Okay, so let us see what we required for this particular topic, or what are the more formulas we require. So here we have the another example. I will go with the AC. Okay. Fine. Fourier series expansion for f of x is equal to x into sine x. Find in zero less than equal to x less than equal to 2 pi. Okay, so this is the another way to write the interval. So you can see this is the closed interval. So for us, that doesn't matter, the open interval or the closed interval. It is for the integration, we always assume both of these things, and that's why it doesn't matter. Okay, now let us see what is the function given, x into sine x. Okay, so that's great. Now, can you tell me whether this is a even function or this is a odd function?
Neither even nor odd.
That's great. Okay, so you got a trick now. Good. Okay, so always we have to see first the interval. Okay, good. Okay, and once you see the interval, then you can have the guess, or you can think of the type of the function, that whether it is given odd or even. So this interval is 0 to 2 pi. and hence we don't have to think much more about that. So we can write directly the Fourier series for this. Okay, so let us see the Fourier series. Okay, now we go with the solution here. Okay, so let f of x is equal to x into sine x b. Defined in 0 to 2 pi. Okay. And hence, the Fourier series expansion of f of x is given as, what you can have is f of x is equal to a0 plus summation n running from 1 to infinity an cos of nx plus summation n running from 1 to infinity bn sine of nx, and this is your equation 1. So here what we get is, since 2l is equal to 2 pi, okay, and hence I am able to get, so I get L is equal to pi. Okay, so once you get L is equal to pi, and we know C is equal to 0. So that we are able to use here, and we can write where A0 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi 0 to 2 pi f of x dx. Then an is equal to 1 upon pi integral 0 to 2 pi f of x cos of nx dx. And we get bn is equal to 1 upon pi 0 to 2 pi f of x sine of nx dx. Okay. So that's what we have. Now you got the idea that we have to find out this a0, an, and bn, and then put this value in equation 1. Okay, so let us try to find out these values. So what I'll have is, consider a0 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi x into sine x dx. So here we are going to use u into v root. Okay, so what we can say is, using generalized five parts rule, so if I use a generalized five parts rule, we get what we are able to get here. See, this is equal to a0 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi. Then here we have this x remains as it is. The integration of sine, which is minus cos x upon 1. Then minus the derivative of this x is going to be 1. And this is going to be minus sine x upon 1 again. So it is 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so this is 1 upon 2 pi, and we get minus x cos x, then minus minus plus sine x, 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so this is going to be easy here, 1 upon 2 pi. Okay, so minus 2 pi cos of 2 pi plus sine of 2 pi is 0, minus, if I use the lower limit here, 0, then this term will be minus minus 0, and sine term is always going to be 0. Okay, so what we know is 1 upon 2 pi, then cos of 2 pi is going to be 1, so it is going to be minus 2 pi. And you can see that 2 pi will get cancelled, and hence I can have this a0 is equal to minus 1. So I got here a0 is equal to minus 1, which is equation 2. Okay, so here we got a0. The next we have to think of an. Okay, so we have an is equal to 1 upon pi 0 to 2 pi x into sine x into cos of nx dx. Okay, so that's what we'll get. Now see what we have here. This is equal to, okay, so we'll get 1 upon pi integral 0 to 2 pi x into sine x into cos of nx dx. Okay, so to integrate, we have to first simplify this product. Okay, 1 upon pi integral 0 to 2 pi x, and here we have this is sine x cos of nx, and we have dx. Okay, so let us simplify this product first. So we have pi, 1 upon pi integral 0 to 2 pi x. Now we have sine a into cos b, so we have half of, okay, then I'll go here, half of sine of a plus b plus sine of a minus b. Okay, so the value of a is x and the value of b is nx. And now we can have 1 upon 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi. This is x into. So here I'll be having the term sine of n plus 1 x plus sine of 1 minus n x dx. Okay. Now this n will be 1 or more than n, 1. So I'll make it like this. So I'll have 1 upon 2 pi 0 to 2 pi x into sine of n plus 1 x minus sine of n minus 1 x and dx. So what I did here, instead of this, I have taken minus sign common, and we know sine of minus theta is minus sine of theta. So using that, we have simplified this term. And now we are able to find, so this is an. So using generalized bypass rule, okay, so we get what we are able to get here. This is equal to 1 upon 2 pi. Okay, so please be careful while integrating. X remains as it is. And integration of this. So what will be the integration of this? So integration of sine is going to be minus cosine. So I'll be having here minus cos of n plus 1 x upon n plus 1. Already we have minus, so minus minus become plus. So cos of n minus 1 into x upon n minus 1. Now minus the derivative of this term. So it is going to be 1. And the integration of this. So I'll be having minus sine of n plus 1 x upon n plus 1 bracket square. Okay. Then this term plus sine of n minus 1 into x upon, we'll be having n minus 1 bracket square. And here we have the limit for this integration 0 to 2 pi. Okay, and now we know these sine terms are going to be 0. So we write here, so this is an. So since sine 0 is equal to sine of 2n pi is equal to 0. So here it is n plus 1, that doesn't matter. So instead of n, we have n plus 1 here. So it will be of the form 2n pi, and therefore it will go 0. Okay. And hence, we get. Hence, we get an is equal to. What is an? We'll be having 1 upon 2 pi. This is going to be x minus cos of n plus 1 x upon n plus 1 and plus cos of n minus 1 x upon n minus 1. And this is 0 to 2 pi. So 1 upon 2 pi. Here I'll be having 2 pi. Okay, so this is minus. So this is going to be minus. Okay, I'll having cos of 2n plus 1 pi. Okay, because x is going to be 2 pi upon n plus 1 plus cos of 2n minus 1 pi upon n minus 1. And minus this is going to be 0. Because x is equal to 0, so all this will go 0. Okay. Now, cos of 2n pi and cos of 2n minus 1 pi. So this is of the form again 2n pi, 2n pi. So it is going to be 1. And hence, we get here 1 upon 2 pi, 2 pi minus 1 upon n plus 1 plus 1 upon n minus 1. So this 2 pi will get cancelled, and I'll be having here, see, this will be minus n minus 1 plus n plus 1 upon n square minus 1. So if you simplify, minus n plus 1 plus n plus 1 upon n square minus 1. So it is 2 upon n square minus 1. So you got here that an is equal to 2 upon n square minus 1. Okay, but what happens if n is 1? Okay, so here this will be not defined for n is equal to 1. So this will give you all the values for n except n is equal to 1. And now if it is not defined for n is equal to 1, then we have to find this value separately. Okay, so let us find this value separately. Okay, then we have a1 is equal to at n is equal to 1. So it is 1 upon pi 0 to pi x sine x into cos x, because n is 1 here. So this is what we'll be having, 1 upon pi integral 0 to 2 pi x, and sine x cos x, this will be sine of 2x by 2, and this is dx. So it is 1 upon 2 pi integral 0 to 2 pi x into sine of 2x dx. Okay, so this is going to be a1. And hence, what we have to do here, we have to find this. So again, using generalized biparts rule, we get. So what we are able to get here, a1 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi. And here, we got x as it is, The integral. See, what is the integral of our sine v of? This is going to be minus cos of 2x by 2 and minus 1. And this is minus sine of 2x by 2 square. And this is 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so again we can say what we are able to say, since sine of 0 is equal to sine of here 2n pi, and that is equal to 0, hence we get, so this term will vanish at both the ends or both the limits, so we get a1 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi. This is minus x cos of 2x upon 2. And that's what you'll be having, 0 to 2 pi. So 1 upon 2 pi minus 2 pi into cos of 4 pi upon 2. And minus minus plus, this is going to be 0. Because 0 is there. Okay. So this is equal to, what we get here, we get 1 upon 2 pi, cos is going to be 1, so this is going to be minus pi, and hence we get minus half. So I have a1 is equal to minus half, and that's what we got here. So we got a1 is equal to minus half. So this is the equation. Next, what we have, 4. It will be 3. So this will be equation 3. So we got already 3, we have got. So this is going to be equation 4. Okay, so now do you have any doubt up to yet? Slight time we are extending because we'll be done with this example, then we'll stop. Okay, so it remains now bn to find. Okay, so that's great. Okay, so let us find bn. Okay, now we consider. Okay, bn is equal to 1 upon pi integral 0 to 2 pi x sine x into sine of nx dx. Okay, so let us simplify this. This is equal to 1 upon pi 0 to 2 pi, and here we have x. This term is, I can write this as sine nx into sine x dx. And then we know 1 upon pi 0 to 2 pi. We got here x. And here this term is cos of. Okay, so a minus b. So nx minus x minus cos of a plus b. So nx plus x and then dx. So sine a into sine b is cos of a minus b minus cos of a plus b. And then here I'll be having this by 2. Okay. So I can take this constant outside. So I'll be having 1 upon 2 pi 0 to 2 pi x, and I'll be having cos of n minus 1 x minus cos of n plus 1 x, and this is dx. So this is what we got, bn. Okay, and now I can say, using generalize biparts rule, we get, what we are able to get is bn is equal to 1 upon 2 pi and here x remains as it is. The integration of this term. So I'll be having sine of n minus 1 x upon, I'll be having n minus 1 minus sine of n plus 1 x upon n plus 1. And now the derivative of this term, so minus 1 and integration of this, minus cos of n minus 1 x upon n minus 1 square and plus cos of n plus 1 x upon n plus 1 bracket square, and here this limit is 0 to 5. Okay, so we know since these sine terms will be vanishing, okay, so we write here, since sine of 0 is equal to sine of 2n pi is equal to 0, hence we get, so what we are able to get here, see, this is bn is equal to 1 upon 2 pi, this minus minus will become plus cos of n minus 1 x upon n minus 1 square minus cos of n plus 1 x upon n plus 1 square, and from limits from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, now see, again this limit will not exist for n is equal to 1. So 1 upon 2 pi is going to be 1 upon n minus 1 bracket square, then I'll have cos of 2n pi is going to be 1. So we have here minus 1 upon n plus 1 bracket square. You are using lower limit, so minus 1 upon n minus 1 bracket square plus 1 upon n plus 1 bracket square, and this is equal to 0. So we get here bn is equal to 0 if n is not equal to 1. So this is equation 5. Then again, if n is not equal to 1, so here if it is not equal to 1, then we have to find what happens if b is equal to, n is equal to 1. Then for n is equal to 1, we have b1 is equal to, okay, so we have to find out what will happen to this b1. Okay, so b1 is equal to 1 upon pi 0 to 2 pi x sine x into sine x dx. So it is 1 upon pi 0 to 2 pi x into sine square x dx. So it is 1 upon pi 0 to 2 pi. Then we have x 1 minus cos of 2x by 2 and dx. So we get here 1 upon 2 pi 0 to 2 pi x 1 minus cos of 2x and we'll be having dx. So let us evaluate this. You'll get 1 upon 2 pi. Then we have here, again you can use u into v rule. So we'll have x as it is, integral of this. So you can have x minus the integral of cosine is going to be sine 2x by 2. Then minus the derivative of this term. So it is going to be 1. And the integral of this. Okay. You can have, this is going to be x square by 2. And minus minus plus, you will have cos of 2x by 2 square. Okay. And this limit is from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, this is equal to 1 upon 2 pi. So we'll be having x square minus x into sine of 2x by 2 minus x square by 2 minus cos of 2x by 4, and the interval is 0 to 5. So let us apply the limit. Okay, so you get d1 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi. So it is going to be 2 pi square minus, this is 0 because sine term is there, minus 2 pi square by 2. This is minus cos of 2 pi is going to be 1. So this is going to be 1 by 4. And you are using lower limit. So this all terms will be 0. This will be plus, and cos term is 1. So I'll be having 1 by 4. So these two terms will get cancelled, and I'll be having 1 by 2 pi. This is 4 pi square minus. Okay, this will be 4 pi square by 2. So it is 1 upon 2 pi. And here you'll be having 4 pi square minus, you have, this is 2 pi square. So 1 upon 2 pi, and you'll be having 2 pi square. So you got V1 is equal to, you got here, this is going to be pi. Okay. So this is your next equation 6. And now we are able to write from equation 1, 2. So from equation 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We get, okay, so we get the Fourier series f of x is equal to, so collect all these terms. Okay, so what we have as a0, okay, so a0 is going to be minus 1, a1 is minus half. Okay, then so you got here, this is going to be minus 1 minus half cos x plus 2 summation n running from 2 to infinity, please be careful here, 1 upon n square minus 1 cos of nx. Bn is 0, but plus pi you will be having sin x. So b1 exists only, and that's what the value. So this is how you are able to get the Fourier series expansion